pretty teeth.
I've been with the company, this is my 12th year.
He shows them pearly white, just a jackknife.
When I started with the company, I was on the production side of our Summits division, worked there for a number of years, and took on operations and marketing as well. Created the CRM division a couple years later as I transitioned over to the sales side, which I did in 2001, and worked my way up through the sales division and took on the role of general manager of San Diego in 2002, and then as COO in 2005.
So there's never a trace of red.
My day-to-day, I wear many hats. First and foremost, at Marcus Evans, I'm a salesman. I have my own clients that I work with, my own deals to close. I'm also responsible for managing a team of individuals who work directly for me, as well as managers and directors who help me run the San Diego and Los Angeles office.
Could that someone perhaps perchance be Mac the Knife?
I started working in the Chicago office, went overseas and lived in Bermuda for a year, came back to Chicago for a number of years before heading down to San Diego, where I now split time between San Diego and LA. But with the company, aside from the great resorts and destinations we've been to at our summits, I've done training in Barcelona, spent a lot of time in Toronto, and love the travels I've been able to have with the company.
He split the scene, babe. After drawing out all the bread.
It sounds cliche, but the most common thing you need is to be self-motivated. Nothing is going to be handed to you here, but every opportunity is available to you. So for me, it takes a certain work ethic, someone to not having someone push you from behind, but for you to lead from the front, for you to know that you wake up every day and get the opportunity to come to work and get the opportunity to make a lot of money is by far, I would say, the biggest thing that will separate those who succeed here from those who don't.
Has Mac Heath's deal, and he keeps it way out of sight.
The opportunities by the company have been fantastic, and we have full company support. The best thing about the company is that we strictly promote from within. So every opportunity is there for any individual who walks in the door. We don't hire sales managers, sales directors, general managers, or chief officers of the company. Everybody in this company has started at the ground floor and proven themselves time and again with the company.
Never a trace of red on a sidewalk one Sunday morning.
I'm aggressive. I don't like taking no for an answer. I love making money. I'm tenacious, and I think most of all, I'm passionate about what we do. I believe in the product. I've seen it work hundreds of times over for my clients. I've helped a lot of people make a lot of money for their companies, and in return, they've been very good to us.
From a tugboat on the river going slow.
Motivating your staff, first and foremost, if they're not motivated themselves and hungry when they walk in the door, I believe they're never going to be. But people with the right attitude still need the right direction. We provide constant training, supervision, coaching, whether it be phone training, daily training sessions, anything that we can do to help our staff develop. And it's always a win-win-win situation. It's when our employees succeed, it's good for them, it's good for us, it's good for the company as a whole, it's good for our clients. And when someone fails, the same thing happens. While it's a negative situation for them, it's the same for us, and we want to make sure that everyone who walks in the door has a great opportunity to succeed.
Hey, that shark has pretty teeth, dear.
I would say that the biggest obstacle that a new person faces is the leap of faith that they have to take when coming into the company. Many of them have been trained in other organizations before, and I believe that every organization should have a proper sales process. Now, some people's sales process are different than the Marcus Evans sales process. Doesn't make that old company right or wrong, but when people walk in, they need to be open-minded to adjusting to a new style. We know it works. We have a very simple value proposition, a very simple product, a very simple way to communicate it. And when it's conveyed well, we're going to win every time.
So there's never a trace of red on a sidewalk.
Between my two offices right now, I've got 40 people. and certainly looking to grow that over the next year.
Who's in life?
Someone sneaking.
On a personal note, my next mission will be to break my own sales record. But overall, I want to make sure that everybody on my team is able to succeed. I want to see, there's nothing that makes me feel better than watching a new person get that first deal. I love being able to promote someone because of the great job they've done. Be able to reward people not only on a monetary value, but also in terms of recognition. And so for me, it's being able to build up a great camaraderie with my colleagues, many of whom have been with us for years, and many of whom, and hopefully more, that will be with us for years to come.
He split the scene, babe.
After drawing out all the bread from his staff.
I keep myself motivated by looking at always wanting to improve myself. I never sit back and wait for my phone to ring. I never sit back and rest on my laurels. I always want to earn more money than I did the year before. I don't ever like taking a step backwards. I've been with this job and with this company long enough that I've seen in great economic times and in terrible economic climates, our model works, and our model can benefit people no matter what the conditions. So therefore, there's really no excuses. It's a matter of, are you hungry enough, are you strong enough, and are you passionate enough about the job, the opportunity, the product, to be able to come in, work hard, and be aggressive, and succeed.
Scarlet billows, they begin to spread.
Well, Marcus Evans, what I liked it from when I came in the doors, even from the person who was hiring me, that they had started on the ground floor. I liked the opportunity coming in only a couple years out of school, out of college, that I had the opportunity to make my own destiny. I didn't have to sit there with a larger company with lots of red tape and put in years of service and wait for people above me to leave or drop off before I was able to succeed. You are able to move at your own pace. Earn whatever you are capable of doing, and write your own ticket.
The knife from a tugboat on the river going slow.
I would say, don't be shy. That's going to be the first rule. You're going to make mistakes. You're going to trip up, and you'll recognize that everybody else who works for the company went through the exact same thing. We all made the same mistakes. We all learn from those mistakes and from others' mistakes, and we'll continue to grow. So don't be shy. Don't be hesitant, and absolutely learn as much as you can about the product, and be passionate about what you're doing, as I believe that passion comes across in the sales process and enables customers to trust us, which ultimately will lead to us closing the deal.
Now Mac, he spins like a sailor. Do you suppose this guy, he did something right?